No one can make you feel inferior without your consent. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, our friend Dr. Tracey Marks talks with us about how to stop feeling like a victim. Enjoy.
In this video, I'll be talking with you about how to break out of the victim mindset. I'll be giving you 5 ways to recognize whether you have this mindset and 5 solutions to break out of this mindset. And why is this even important? Because setbacks and disappointments and hurts, they're all part of the uncertainty of life. How you respond to these setbacks determines how satisfied you are or will be with your life. You can't control your circumstances, but you can control your response to them. So, how do you know if you're wallowing in victimization? Here's 5 ways to recognize it. Number 1, most things have a negative tone to them. You can even get to the point where you feel like life just isn't even on your side, or you've been dealt a really bad set of cards. Number 2, you ask yourself why a lot. Why does everything in my life have to be hard? Why can't people just leave me alone? Why don't people understand me? Number 3, you mull over things a lot. The psychological term for this is ruminate. Picture a cow chewing cud for hours. This is what can go on in your head when you're thinking about your life. The script just runs over and over, and nothing seems to work out for you. I never seem to get fill in the blank. Why bother? Because I always fill in the blank. Number 4, you don't think very highly of yourself. You are your own worst critic. You feel like damaged goods, which means you don't deserve very good things. Number 5, your first emotion is anger, and you're often resentful of other people's gains. An example of this may be you resent the fact that your best friend got a $7,000 bonus at work. She already has nice things. Why is she always the one who gets these things? These things never seem to happen to you. Do any of these sound familiar to you? Sometimes you can slip into the victim mindset only in certain areas of your life. It can be subtle, but persuasive enough to hold you back or even lower your self-esteem. Here are 5 solutions to break out of this way of thinking. Number 1, build confidence by creating small, achievable goals. Think of this as like starting with one of those huge, large 100-piece baby puzzles and then moving up to the 1,000-piece mega puzzle. If you're convinced that good things never happen to you, you have to retrain your mind to see that you can win at something, even if it's something small. Then you have to give yourself time to reflect or ruminate on these small accomplishments with the intention of moving on to even bigger accomplishments. Number 2, turn your attention to giving to others. Victimization breeds neediness, and the more needy you are, the more opportunity you have to be disappointed when your needs aren't met. So adopt the approach of getting by giving first. Meeting someone else's needs allows you to rise above the victim mode and by being someone's hero. The satisfaction that you can get from loving or showing love to others gives you a reason to love yourself. And when you love yourself, you build a hedge of protection around yourself to guard against future hurts. Number 3, make a gratitude list. You've probably heard this before, but when you're in victim mode, you focus more on what you don't have and you lose sight of the things that you do have. So you change your perspective by spending more time counting your blessings when you write these things down. And you can remind yourself of these things later when you slip back into feeling sorry for yourself. So you actually have them that you can pull them out from a piece of paper and read them. Number 4, get closure on your past hurts. And this may involve forgiving someone. It may involve forgiving yourself. If you blame yourself for continuing to make the same mistakes over and over or trusting the same wrong person, you need to do the following. You need to understand what draws you to these bad decisions in the first place, and this will take some work. You may need the help of a therapist or a counselor or even a good friend who knows you very well. But once you have a good handle on your pattern, you press the reset button and you trust that you can move on to better decisions in the future. Number 5, take ownership of your decisions. No one can make you feel a certain way without you allowing it. And if you're around people who make you feel bad, maybe because they're critical of you, then you've got to limit your contact with them because they're not helping you. And sometimes you don't have the option of never seeing them because it's a family member, maybe a parent. In that case, you have to set an emotional distance between you and that person to protect yourself from always being hurt by them. So don't let past hurts define you. Identify how you may be wallowing in victim mode so that you can put it behind you. You have the power to rid yourself of the victim persona, but it will be a daily ongoing process that requires a lot of effort, but it does become easier the more you rid yourself of that victim mindset. Here's a challenge for you. Identify a way that you're wallowing in victim mode, and here's two ways you can start with this. Do you have a why bother mindset about because you failed at something so many times? Or are people always having to give you a pep talk? If so, choose one of the 5 solutions and apply it to your situation and implement it.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.